जनरली व्हेन आई टेक और कंडक्ट एनी नेचर ट्रेल, पीपल आस्क मी और टेल मी दैट वी हैड विजिटेड कान्हा, गीर, रणथंबोर एंड डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वाइल्ड लाइफ सेंचुरीज थ्रू आउट वर्ल्ड टू स्पॉट और टू सी टाइगर्स एंड लायंस. बट ड्यूरिंग आवर ट्रिप वी कुडंट सी एनी सिंगल टाइगर और एनी सिंगल लायन. जनरली आफ्टर दिस स्टेटमेंट आई आस्क पीपल, हैव यू नोटिस एनी इंसेक्ट ओवर देयर? सो दे जनरली ऑब्वियसली दे रिफ्यूज इट. सो नो, वी ओनली फोकस ऑन एनिमल्स, बिगर बिगर एनिमल्स. बट हियर वेरी वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थिंग इज दैट लुक दिस पाई चार्ट. हियर यू कैन सी दिस मैमल्स एंड जस्ट नोटिस हियर हाउ मच दे आर, एंड हियर यू कैन सी ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स. So instead of focusing on insect biodiversity, these people, but this is not their fault, these people focus on other animals, and we obviously overlook this insect biodiversity. Now, what are insects? Which animal is called as insect? Main thing, insects have three body parts. I will show you. This is head, this is thorax, and this is abdomen. Abdomen has segments, means we cover this. Now three pairs of legs, one, two, and three, same at other side. We completed this also. One pair of antenna, two pairs of wings. This is one, this is second. Body is very very hard due to external skeleton. We all have internal bone structure. They have chitinous exoskeleton which support their body parts. Then they have compound eyes. Compound eyes means what? We have one lens in our eye. Insects have hundreds of lenses per eye. I am giving example of our very common insect, housefly. Housefly have 450 lenses, means 450 eyes per eye. So if you calculate, our housefly have 900 lenses, means 900 eyes. Now if one housefly is sitting observing you, it's can see 900% in front of her. So बोलते हैं ना, मक्खी मारना, माशा मारत बसना. So this is not a simple task. If you try to kill house fly, it will fly immediately. So it is very conscious, what called as behavior. Then last is jointed appendages. You can see this. These are all joints. If you fulfill all these things, then that animal is called as insect. And now people think spider also insect, plant lice also insect. So which type of animals are not insect? Sabse main people think spiders are insect, but how they are not insect, I will tell you. Spider body is divided into two parts. One is head having four legs, and second is abdomen. So main thing is the difference between number of body parts. Insect have three, spider have two. Insect have two compound eyes, and spiders have just you think before my statement, you can think your answer. How many eyes spiders have? Spiders have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 eyes. So here again, second thing that spiders are not insect. I will just give a second example of plant louse. We know louse in our head or our skin or in case of animals, but plant louse is again a different types of animal which have plenty of legs. How many legs I told you in case of insects? Three pair, means six legs. And here in case of plant louse, you can see n number of legs. Then earthworm, no legs. Centipede, yes. Now tell me how many legs? plenty of legs. But here there is a difference between centipede and millipede. Centipede have one pair of leg per segment. In Marathi, you know one animal called as ghon. Aplya ghari ghon aste. Like this is centipede. Now millipede, two pair of legs per segment. In Marathi, it is called as paisa. When you touch this animal, it coils itself like chuckling of the Diwali. So this is again obviously not insect. And last but not least, snail. We all know no legs, no exoskeleton, no compound eyes, no wings. So snail is but obvious not insect. So what is the unique thing about insect? I showed in my earlier pie chart that maximum amount of faunal part is occupied by insects. More than 90 lakh insects are discovered yet, and scientists think that same number of insects are going to be discovered in few years. So just imagine number of or richness in biodiversity of insect. Second thing, they are found in each and every continent including Antarctica. Now very unique thing is that in Antarctica there is the largest terrestrial animal, and this is nothing but our insect today's topic. And largest means how much large? Just 2 millimeter to 5 to 6 millimeters in length. So just imagine how minute this is, but then also it is the largest terrestrial animal in Antarctica. Second thing, I'm giving example. If in any accident, head of cockroach breaks or gets separated, then also it can survive for hours, because this insect, all insect, they breathe through their unique things. I will show you those in my another photos. They do not have mouth to breathe, so they respire by some other openings which are present on their body. Then unique thing, how many chambers our heart have? 4. Blood gushes through arteries and veins, and this is called as blood circulation. In case of insects, there is no blood vessels. In case of cockroach have 13 segmented heart, and which is at posterior side of his body, at back side. So heart pumps its blood, which is watery color, and that blood enters into cracks and crevices of all tissues. There is no blood vessels in the cockroach body. Same applies for each and every insect. I covered this part about the eyes, so I will not repeat. Now how they reproduce. There are two types of reproduction types in case of insects. This part is found in grasshoppers, cockroach and locust. Female lays eggs hatch with babies which are same identical as adults but lack of wings. After few molting, called as metamorphosis. Molting means kath takne in Marathi, jaise snake molds by removing its skin. So after few moltings, nymph enters into adult stage. Now we will see the second part. It is called as complete metamorphosis. In case of this, it is incomplete metamorphosis. It is complete. Complete means egg, as you all know, egg, larvae, pupa or cocoon, and then after pupation, means pupa, it convert into adult. And this can be seen in butterflies, moth, flies, bees, wasp, dragonfly, damselfly, everything. So this is main two types of metamorphosis. And now be ready to explore this unique world of insects around you. First, now one very important thing, name of each and every insect will appear after few seconds. I will give you time to think whether you know this insect or not. So everything not will be spoon fed. आपको सोचना है, आपको इस इंसेक्ट का नाम मालूम है क्या? So this is harvester ant. What it do? It name suggests that it harvests. What it harvests? Here you can see husk. Husk means outer coating of any grain. Now you can see here, it is empty. It is empty. So where it is? Where is the grain? Grain is inside their nest. So what they do? They collect the grain with the husk from the nearby area like a jungle forest. Then they put this grain inside their home. Some workers separate husk from the grain, and this grain is stored inside their specific chamber, and this husk is then throughout of their nest. So why they do this? This whole process is carried out in pre-monsoon and post-monsoon season. In case of monsoon, when there is a waterlog everywhere, these ants stay inside and utilize these already collected grains as their main food. So this is actually bolte hai ki what it is called as accumulation karna of food. Now this is a unique fly and the name is robber fly. Yes, it robs. What it robs? In Marathi it is called darode khormashi, means it ambush inside bushes, and when it spot any insect, fine insect, it attack on that and it capture that, and in the flight only it consume that insect. Now in my earlier slide I told you that insect may or may not have two pairs of two pairs of wings. In case of flies, they have only one pair of fully developed wings, and second pair you can see here, and this is called as halter. This is called as balancing organ while flight. These flies, not only robber fly, all flies, gharmashi tumcha ghari asti ti sudha, our house fly is also very very evolved animal, called as evolved insect, which have unique part or wing which is developed into a balancing organ called as halter. This robber fly have very very strong mouth parts for biting and chewing. Yes, anyone know this name? Look the color. Yes, it's painted grasshopper. And can you identify the leaf? Hindus use this leaf on Saturday for Lord Hanuman. This is called as rui, wild cotton. We use these leaves for making gatherings for Hanuman, and this is very very poisonous plant. Now I was telling you about the special respiratory organs of insects. Now look very very carefully. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. These are openings for air exchange. This part is only for mouth, sensory organs like antenna as well as eyes. And for respiration purpose, insects use this type of mechanism. And this unique thing about this grasshopper is, this grasshopper consume leaves of this rui called as wild cotton, which is toxic, and store this toxic material in their body. So you can read, when they get called as disturbed by birds or other animals, they squirt a jet of liquid several inches away from their body, and this is very very toxic and poisonous and have very stinky smell. So they get but obvious this defense mechanism with the help of this unique liquid. Yes, can you name this? Yeah, I know this is mosquito, but Can you name unique name of this? Look the pattern. Yes, it is zebra mosquito. Now this is responsible for different types of diseases. You can see dengue, chikungunya, Zika fever, and yellow fever also. And one bad thing, डरा नहीं है आपको, लेकिन दिस इज द फैक्ट दैट इन क्रिकसाइड कॉलोनी एंड बट ऑब्वियस मैंग्रोव 98% मॉस्किटो कॉल्ड एज मॉस्किटो पॉपुलेशन इज नथिंग बट ज़ेब्रा मॉस्किटो. डोंट वरी, डोंट स्टॉप एंटरिंग इन टू मैंग्रोव. आई एम देयर टू गाइड यू प्रॉपरली. बट द यूनिक थिंग इज दिस ईच एंड एवरी मॉस्किटो इज कैरियर ऑफ एनी एट इज वन डिजीज कैरियर. बट इन मैंग्रोव इन एट जेट्टी एरिया एट creek colony, these are isolated mosquitoes. If there is no man or person with dengue, you no need to afraid that hame mujhe bhi dengue ho jayega. So this is just carrier. Can you identify this ant? No, it is ant mantis, a ultimate example of mimicry. This ant mantis is actually 10 to 15 times bigger than ants, and its main food is ant. It enters at the row or the movement of the ants and it catch the ant and consume it. Can you identify this? We all know this insect, but this is so close that you may get confused. So this is honeybee. And why this honeybee is very, very important, you can see this part. This part is called as honeycomb. Sorry, it is called as honey basket. Now, when that this honeybee visit any flower, this pollen get stuck to this basket, and then this emptied this basket inside their beehive. Now what is the process of making honey? Anyone know about this? I will tell you. This honey is nothing but regurgitated out semi-digested pollens, saliva, enzymes, stomach enzymes of honeybee. मैं ऐसे बोलने के बाद भोजन हनी कंज्यूम करना छोड़ेंगे, बट ऐसे नहीं है. दिस हनी है ह्यूज इम्पोर्टेंस इन आयुर्वेदा ऑल्सो, इवन इन यूरोपियन कंट्रीज, इंग्लैंड एंड अमेरिका ऑल्सो दे यूज दिस हनी स्प्रे और हनी बैंडेज ऑन गैंग्रीन. सो एक्चुअली वी ऑल नो दैट गैंग्रीन इज इनक्यूरेबल वुंड इन केस ऑफ सम डायबिटिक पेशेंट, बट ड्यू टू दिस हनी देर इज अ ह्यूज इम्प्रूवमेंट इन दैट वुंड थिंग. So this honey is very, very important, and in India there are two main honeybees. One is Indian honeybee, in common language, local language, called as Satheri, and rock honeybee. It builds its nest or honeycomb in buildings and mountains. Actually, you are familiar if you observe high school building, our Udaichal Primary, Udaichal High School, on third and fourth floor there are huge honeycombs. So these honeycombs are of rock honeybee, which is very, very large, 3 or 4 times larger than our normal Indian honeybee. Now this is an unique moth. As Tejasri told you in her earlier introductory session, that this is called as bird dropping moth. You can see this moth, this is called exactly looks like bird dropping, and here you can see the eyes, antenna, and this is again some sensory structures. So this is unique part, and here you can see some grain like structure, something is here, and this ant is approaching this it's called this moth. So some dew drops secrete out from this bird dropping moth. So this ant get food, and ultimately when ants are there, no one will try to touch this bird dropping moth. So it also get support from this ant. So it is again a part of a type of symbiotic association. Yeah, this is housefly. No, This is blue butterfly. You all are aware about this fly. This fly is very, very common in fish market. And second thing, have you seen very bad condition wound in the dogs? कुत्ते को जख्म होती है ऑन द हेड ऑन द नेक एंड द बैक साइड, उसमें कीड़े होते हैं. ऑल दिस कीड़े मींस ऑल दिस वर्म्स आर नथिंग बट बेबीज ऑफ दिस ब्लू बटरफ्लाई. दिस वर्म्स आर कॉल्ड एज स्क्रू वर्म्स बिकॉज दे हैव द टिपिकल एयर पैटर्न लाइक द वर्ल्स ऑफ द स्क्रू. दिस वर्म्स दिस कॉल्ड एज मैगट्स. Worms of the fly called as maggot. These maggots can bore or can drill inside the bone also. So as soon as there is a rupture in the skull of the dog, it will die because obviously blood, that's worms will enter into the skull and start eating the brain. So bolte hain kutte ki maut marna. So this is due to this blue butterfly. Now this is something unique. Blister bleater. You know blister. 25-26 minutes ho gaye mere abhi. So this is blister beetle. It spray a poisonous chemical that causes blister to our skin if that touches to our body. Now itna uska fayda hai kya? No. Now I will show you something. This is the posterior part of this beetle. This is that opening. And these are two sacs. Sac number one have say chemical one. Sac number two have chemical two. These are very simple chemicals, but as soon as these chemicals enter here and when they mix in each other, they form very, very strong burning boiling chemical called caustic acid. And this caustic acid gets spread outside body. This caustic acid is so powerful that this caustic acid can burn the self tissues also. This is very common insect. Carpenter bee. It is in Marathi called as bhunga. Here you can see again pollens. Again it is very, very unique or economically important insect for agriculture part. This insect always in search of holes for home to lay eggs. Mainly old bamboos which are used in construction industry, you can see, you might have seen the holes in the bamboo, and this is due to this female of this carpenter bee, and the name is here due to this same reason, carpenter bee. Now this is again unique insect, alcid wasp. Unique because name is also unique. I think you are 100% sure that you are never came across this name, alcid wasp. What it do? This wasp have a injection like needle at the end of the body, and here this needle is in resting position, is folded like this. This wasp oviposit, means lay eggs inside the body of other insects or inside the eggs of other insects. What is the reason behind this? When that egg hatches inside the body of insect or inside the egg of other insects, it get ready made food. Matlab dusre ke body ke andar rehke usko hi kha jana. And this is very, very unique thing. Now this wasp is also again have economical importance in agriculture. In agriculture there are many pest insects like locust, like other beetles, like sap sucking bugs. These destroy all the field in the agriculture, and that time this chalcid was used as god for the farmers. This wasp at one time lays more than 400 eggs in the body of 400 other insects. So one wasp can kill 400 other pest insects. So very, very important wasp. You know this in Marathi called as Lal Mungya, Lal Chitti. It is Chromatogaster ant. How to identify this ant? Look very carefully. Look the shape, heart shape. So heart shape abdomen is a unique thing in case of Chromatogaster ants. Can you identify the leaf on which they are aggregated, they are present? It is nothing but Miswak plant tree. These ants have formic acid. This formic acid have the itchy sensation. So whenever they bite us, formic acid enters into our body, which dissolve our tissues, which cause itchy sensation. खा जाते हैं आप पहले, खुजली आती है. See, this is due to Chromatogaster ant. There are n number of species of ants, commonly known as black ants and white black ants and red ants, but these are the most unique or most abundant species which are present in mangroves and in your nearby also. Dragonfly? No, it is damselfly. This is sister of dragonfly. So what is the difference? Look the head. Now I will go further. Look the difference. This is dragonfly and this is damselfly. In case of dragonfly, both eyes are separated by a notch. In case of damselfly, eyes are totally differentiated from each other. Second difference, in case of dragonfly, look the position of the wing. In case of damselfly, they are upwardly directed. Damselfly, broad abdomen. Dragonfly, broad abdomen. Damselfly, very narrow. So it is called as Tasani in Marathi. And this is called as helicopter. Many people identify this or pronounce as helicopter because it hover like helicopter. At jetty, if you visit this place, jetty place at during the monsoon season, you can see hundreds and thousands of dragonflies hovering at jetty area. These dragonfly and damselfly, unique thing, their nymphs are predatory and they spend 1 year and half year, means 1 year and 6 months in water as an aquatic insect. And during this, they consume a larvae of mosquito. So they control mosquito population also. And after last molting or last shedding of skin, they become young. This is not butterfly because this is not my part. Tomorrow there is a butterfly session. So this is a moth called as geometrid moth or also called as flat moth. It is so flat that if it is sitting or resting on a leaf, you can see a white paper is there. So it is actually two dimensional, so very, very flat body. Now this is a unique moth on mangroves called as pneumatophore moth. If there are students there in this session, they know this word pneumatophore. It is a type of roots in case of mangrove, the roots which come out from the water or soil. What this pneumatophore moth do, it rests upside down, like they wait for tide. When tide rises, they climb on the tree trunk and rest over there. Moths are very, very sedentary. They hardly fly because moths do not have mouth parts. They use the stored food material, the stored which food they consume in their larval stage. So they have to conserve their body called as calorie. So this is the thing about the moth. And unique thing about this is antennae are very, very long. Third largest moth in mangrove, it is called as Indian owlet moth. look, the pattern, it is like large eyes of the owl. And the second thing is snake-like pattern, the fang of snake. So this is again unique thing in the, not only mangrove, you can see this moth in our colonies also. And now this is the second most largest, the largest moth, tusser silk moth, reshmacha patang apan tala manto. And this is second most largest, called as owl moth. You can see the actual eye-like structure in this moth. The unique thing about this moth is male can smell or detect female from 10 kilometers away. So these antennas are very, very powerful. And just, can you identify this moth? This is your, like your family member. You have spotted this moth n number of times in your home during pre-monsoon season. This is called a tick defoliating moth, Hablia. During pre-monsoon season, millions and billions of moths attack on mangrove and destroy or completely defoliate each and every leaf of mangrove. And they are in so large number, they migrate from mangrove forest to schools, to Skrikside colony, then railway tracks, then everywhere till this colony ke piche kya, it is called as what is behind that our hillside colony, so I don't know the name. So they migrate everywhere, and you can see hundreds of plants, hundreds of moths during the peak season. Yeah, this is something new. Can you name this? Snake is like which animal? It is giraffe. It is giraffe beetle. Though it is beetle, it is weevil. And what is weevil? Have you spotted some small insect in your wheat, gehu mein, in your pulse dal mein, black color ke, there are many insects. These are weevil. Look this mouth part. These are called as, this mouth part are crushing type of mouth parts. These destroy all our food grain. And this giraffe beetle or giraffe weevil is no exception. In case of male, they have the huge neck. In case of female, neck is very small, this much of only. This same species is found in mangroves also. This is unique insect again. This is called a jasseed. This insect oozes out, as I told you earlier, in case of other that bird, the bird dropping moth, some honeydews or honey droplets from the body, and ants get attracted. So again, it shows symbiotic association between the jasseed, this is called as bug, and ants. And this is again a sapsucker. This is the main pest of milky mangrove. These bugs suck sap from the milky mangrove and destroy that plant, jewel bug. This is a cousin brother of grasshopper called as katydid. Posterior part is like sickle, reverse sickle shape. This is called as ovipositor, by which they lay eggs. This is the nocturnal animal. Again, it is one of the largest insect in the world. One of the, not largest. It is called as long horn beetle. Horn means this antennas. So the total body length is more than 5 to 6 inches. Hard shell. Body part, you can see these claws. These are chewing and biting type. It is omnivorous insect, feed upon all organic material, including other insects also. What is this? Actual insect is this much only. And all this part is waxy secretion from its body. It is called as mealybug. Have you seen papaya tree leaves? Sometime you can see some powdery coating or secretion throughout the papaya. So this powdery secretion is nothing but this mealybug waxy coating. These are also sap sucker. Few mealybugs can kill 1 to 2 feet of bush in a day. So just imagine how much speedily they are sucking the sap, and due to dehydration, plants die. So this is the main pest of agricultural field, mealybug. Again, very common. In your lifetime, n number of time you have seen this structure, and you might know the name also. Yes, pagoda ant nest. Now, when I ask you the question, how this made, you might tell me that due to this is made by the use of leaf of the neighboring plant. No, this structure is cellulose, semi-digested cellulose from the mouth of ants called as pagoda ants. And the unique thing is about this is this structure is antibacterial, antifungal, and during rain also you can't see any fungal growth on the structure. Look the roof structure, it is like this. Opening is at underside. So though when there is a huge number of waterfall, water will not enter into this in their nest. Rufous woodpecker is a bird which lay eggs inside this pagoda ant nest. What is the benefit to both? This rufous woodpecker female feeds their chick, and remaining food is consumed by ant, and ants get protection to this chick. So again, this is symbiotic association. Just 1 or 2 minutes, please. This is again paper wasp. You might think that this is again a honeybee, but no, paper wasp. Huge fangs and painful this bite, but people now think that these ants starts making paper in ancient time. People think that Chinese invested paper, but no, this paper wasp are the main creator of this paper. They use this dead wood stem and some fibers from the tree, and they mix in the saliva, get semi-digested, paper-like structure forms. You can see this, the babies inside. This is called as pentatomid bug. Count 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 points, so called pentatomid bug. Again, they are some called as a pest in agriculture. They suck sap and kill the plants. They also are called as stink bug because they again spray stinky jet of liquid to repel predators. This is again very very common, cotter wasp. You can read here, Native Americans got idea of making earthen pots with the help of this cotter wasp only. It is continuing the search of mud. If mud is not there, it collects dry soil, and this dry soil is getting mixed with saliva, and they make its nest. Can you identify this? Again, very very simple. It is praying mantis. This female sometimes show cannibalism. After mating, it eats its own male only. Why praying mantis? It is called as Prarthana Kitak in Marathi. Look this front pair, it is like worshipping something, so called praying or Prarthana Kitak, and it have the very strong comb like structures to capture prey and pierce its body, puncture its body. It is can wait in the same position for hours for waiting the prey, and this is again camouflage. Again, a very very unique or common pest of cotton called as red cotton bug. It consumes a sap from plant as well as it seeds as well as pods of the cotton. This is called as horsefly because have you seen हॉर्सेस कैटल्स वैग देयर टेल्स टू गेट रिड ऑफ फ्रॉम द फ्लाई. कौन सी फ्लाई होती है? यही फ्लाई वो. एंड दिस फ्लाई ऑल्सो फाउंड एट द फिश मार्केट एज वेल एज द वे देयर इज बुचरीज एंड लार्वी फीड अपॉन द डिकेइंग मीट. दिस इज सिकाडा. सिकाडा मीन्स नथिंग बट रात कीड़ा. And after some time, now it's going to be 7. After 8, you can see the song of the cicada. Have you seen this? This is a spitting bug. Baby spitting bug, or also called nymph, is inside. When it is become adult, it come out from the froth, or called as this spitting froth. And it is called as frog hopper. Insect again, can you find this? Yes, it is here, stick insect. And the longest insect in the world is nothing but stick insect only. And you can read here, there are 222.3 inches long megastick, class megastick stick insect. It is carnivorous insect. It consume, it feeds upon other insects. So called as insectivore insect. White ants, also called as termites. So I will not give the details of this because the time is very very less. And one unique thing is about the queen of the termite has the longest lifespan in the insect world. It stays for 30 to 50 years. Fastest running insect, it is called as a tiger beetle. Look here, per second, this is speed, 9 km per hour. Tortoise shell beetle, you can see this tortoise shaped shell. This is water strider. Look the surface tension of the water. There they have the microscopic hairs in their body, mainly in their legs, which are hydrophobic, so they can float on the water. So what we can do to conserve this insect biodiversity? So plant only native trees, because the native trees are the food for these herbivorous insects. Then avoid use of poisonous insecticides, avoid use of chemical fertilizers. Normal manures are okay. Then please minimize the use of pollutants. Spread awareness among students, citizens, by lectures, seminars, presentations like this. And please don't leave any footprint after going or while going for the nature trail. So thank you very much for being with me for this incredible journey of this insect world. Thank you very much.